Headspace. I've been using it since 2016. Everyone. Today, we're gonna do some talking and some light tapping, maybe. First, I wanna welcome you all to the Kiro ASMR channel. This is something my wife and I have been wanting to do. Started. We hope you like what you see. I don't really know what to say here. I was started of thinking of doing an improv storytelling ASMR. I'm a writer. And I'm not saying I'm a good story is about an orphan girl, or she's not really an orphan, just it's kind of like one of those communities where all the children are raised by all the parents, like all the adults. If I wake up late, my routine kind of is hard to follow. I wake up, I meditate, I walk the dogs, I come back, I eat, I have breakfast, which is usually just a fruit and a piece of bread, and then I come upstairs and I give the dogs their food. Sigh of relief, and you know that it's gonna be okay. this was like, you get to this day where you wake up and you're just like, oh, none of my problems bother me anymore. None of my problems affect me, and I'm just happy every day. And I realized that's not exactly it. I think it was romanticized, this idea of happiness. I'm a happy person, and I didn't used to be, but what I feel is like I still get stressed, I still get sad, I still get worried, I still have concerns. But it's how you relate to those problems and how you let them affect you. There will always be problems. There will always be obstacles. Says, oh, when next week my life will be a lot less chaotic. I'll have more time and I'll be better rested to do my my projects, my side projects. But every week, at the end of the week, something happens, or they have to, you know, they get tired, they get burned out or something. Like when I wanted to start writing my first book in 2016. I kept thinking, but before I had the idea in my head for years before that, and I kept thinking, oh, when I have more time, when I'm done with work, when I feel relaxed, we keep putting these obstacles, right? And we look for this perfect condition, but really, we have to just understand that life will always have to go to the supermarket, you have to clean the house, you have to cook, or, you know, there are multiple things, hundreds of things that it could be for each person. Each person has a different life. You know, it could be homework, it could be studying, yeah, it could be regular work, it could be anything. And so, we have to learn how to relate to those things in a way that they don't overwhelm us, and that's hard. Not easy. I'm not saying that it's easy. So, for example, what I am a freelancer, a translation freelancer, and I have been for a while since 2013. I started getting some gigs, you know, and some stuff, but I only became full-time freelancer in 2014. I'm done with this project, then I'll be free. But then another project comes that's unexpected. And then what do? It's hard, right? So what I had to do was I started increasing my deadlines. So if I could translate, for example, 6,000 words in a day, I started translating for maybe 5,000, and I would start working on my book. It's just what worked for me, right? I know that not everybody is a freelancer, and I know that it's difficult. I had a lot of 9-to-5 jobs. Hell, I've had a lot of 8-to-6 jobs, and it was really, really hard to stay motivated. It was really, really hard to stay focused and to do what I wanted to do. I think each person has the strength within them to find that path for them. And maybe it's difficult, but just knowing the path and striving.